Well, a bunch of bizarre new household trends are sweeping our suburbs.
Could mean anything.
Sounds like a Tom Cruise movie. For the last 100 years, the average Australian household size has been on the decline, until now. These days, more and more people from different families or multiple generations are living under the one roof, giving a whole new meaning to the phrase, one big happy family.
Yeah, by next year, for the first time ever, researchers predict the national or traditional, sorry, nuclear family will no longer be the norm.
So what are the top three new living situations taking over Aussie households? Social analyst and demographer Mark McCrindle joins us now with more. Mark, nice to see you again.
Great to see you.
Nuclear families could be a thing of the past, right? Or is it we're just redefining what a nuclear family is, in fact?
Well, they have historically. The couple with children household has been the most common household form and still is. But by next year, the couple-only household will be the new number one. And this is partly that couples are delaying having kids. Having kids used to be early 20s. That was the average age. Now it's early 30s. So they're couple-only for longer in life. Plus, one in four households are solo-person households. One in 10 households are single-parent households. Group households emerging. So a lot more household types, meaning the nuclear family is actually declining.
So there's no such thing as normal. That's the way it should be. Three generations under one roof. Let's talk about that.
Well, the baby boomers have been labelled the sandwich generation for clear reasons. They're being sandwiched between the care of their children, sometimes adult children, and now the care of their elderly parents as well. And sometimes those parents moving into, you know, their home. So you've got the grandparents, the parents, the children under the one roof. Sometimes their adult children are even returning home with their own children in tow. So that would make four generations in the one household.
Oh, that's a lot of fighting over the remote right there. What are some of the pros and cons of living in that sort of situation?
Well, those who are in that situation say that there's a lot more social interaction. A quarter of households are solo person households. They're more isolated, more disconnected. If you've got the multi-generations, you've just got more of that relational interaction. The young children have grandparents, not just parents, to look out for them, more support for the parents so they can work. But the downside is the cost. It's very expensive, and the pressures, the sandwich, if you like, being pressured on the baby boomers, the care for their elderly parents, the care for their kids is a challenge. And they sometimes can feel taken for granted, that they're doing all the cleaning, all the costing, people aren't you know, contributing.
Oh, that's why you get the mum and dad to move back in, because they've got time on their hands. Boomerang kids. So these are the young adults coming. They might move out when they're 22.
Yes.
When they're 25, they move back in again. We call those boomerangs, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
The majority of children in their late 20s living with their parents had already moved out, but have boomeranged on back, most within 2 years. They just didn't make it, mainly because of costs. It's pretty expensive out there. Half never moved out, but the majority came on back. And that's because the rental market is pretty tight, it's expensive. They're in study later in life, they're starting their earning years later, so they just need to live at home, really, to save up for that mortgage.
Yeah, so some parents stand at the door with open arms, others change the locks, right, when they hear this coming on. Well, but kids could be saving a lot, and that's the reasoning behind it. How much money could kids save by moving back home?
A lot. I mean, even if they're saving about $300 a week on rent, which is sharing rent, I mean, that's pretty low. That's about $15,000 a year just in rent. If they're saving a bit on food, maybe not having to buy some furniture, that's about $20,000. You do that for 2 to 3 years, you've now got enough for a deposit on a mortgage. So that's a big heads up for the kids.
Which is great for the young adults, but what does that mean for the retirement plans of the older mum and dad?
It's definitely having an impact, and it's delaying that retirement. These stay-at-home kids have been called the Kippers generation. That's an acronym. Kids in parents' pockets eroding retirement savings.
Or smelly fish.
But it is having an impact on both the timing of the parents' retirement. You know, they're in a big home. They don't need to be. They could downsize. They can invest that money. And also just the cost. They're sharing the car. They're paying extra for the food and the electricity that otherwise they wouldn't have to have. So I think the kids do have to make a contribution if they're staying longer.
We touched on it. Couples' living arrangements have also changed dramatically in recent years. What do we know about that situation?
Well, it can get a bit awkward because often a family might split up, but they can't afford to head out and buy their own home. The average age of a couple separating is age 38. There's on average two kids involved in that separation, and that's at the time when perhaps someone's out of the workforce because they're raising the young kids.
Right.
They can't afford to go out and buy their own home. So you've got sometimes the exes living together under the one roof. Managing the kids, a bit awkward there.
Of course they have to.
They have to, can't afford to move out.
A little bit awkward. Just something briefly I wanted to touch on with you was the birth rate. It's going up, so more people are having more kids.
That's right, record births, 300,000 births. That's bigger than the baby boom after World War II. So, and that's not so much women who weren't having children now having them. About one in four women are remaining without children. It's that those who were having one are now having a second. Those with two are going for a third. So a little bit of an increase in the family size.
Which is interesting.
So sometime in the next 10 to 15 years, we expect our ratings to go through the roof.
More people than ever.
More people on the couch watching the morning show. Thank you, mate.
Thanks, Mark.
That's a good prediction.
Yeah, interesting snapshot too, isn't it, of our living arrangements. Thank you.